What's up, guys? This is VinylicPuma, back with another Borderlands 2 countdown, and now that I've gone over 10 of the best weapon parts in Borderlands 2, it's probably a good idea we talk about 10 of what I would consider to be some of the worst. Now, before we start, and like last time, this video is going to focus on a wide variety of weapon parts, and will act as more of a general guide of parts to avoid on various weapons. The reason I'm categorizing this list this way is because what weapon parts are best or worst can greatly vary from weapon to weapon. However, this video will be going over weapon parts that are either just redundant or truly suck for their specific weapon types. As always, feel free to let me know what you think are some of the worst weapon parts in the comment section below, and if you're looking for a reference for all of the weapon parts in Borderlands 2, I'll leave a link to some infographics in the video description. But alright guys, enough intro, more video, and let's go ahead and start with number 10, and that is going to be the Vladov Spinny Gun Assault Rifle Barrel. So this will definitely be a controversial pick for some. After all, provided this spawns on a Jacobs weapon, you'll get the awesome Jacobs Gatling Gun Assault Rifle, which is semi-automatic, has a x3 projectile multiplier, and fires about as fast as you can pull the trigger, which is pretty awesome. I might also even give the Doll variant some leeway, as it is functionally pretty similar to most other Doll assault rifles, in that it immediately achieves its maximum fire rate as soon as you pull the trigger. So I suppose two Vladov spinny gun variants range somewhere from being good to excellent. However, literally every other Vladov spinny gun barreled weapon, including some of the legendaries, either suck or are immensely aggravating to use. All of them have to be fired over a period of time so that they can rev up to their maximum damage potential, which just takes way too long. Plus, it's also worth mentioning that even the unique or legendary variants, like the Shredifier, are held back by this obnoxious property. Sure, the Ogre is pretty good, but honestly, which would you rather have? A Borderlands 2 Ogre or a Borderlands 1 variant that achieves its maximum fire rate as soon as you pull the trigger? It's up to you, but I would avoid the Torg Spitter, as well as the Vladoff and Bandit Spinny Guns. Hopefully, the rev-up design never returns in a future Borderlands game. Number 9. Bandit Scopes. While you might think having a weapon spawn with no weapon scope or sight is worse, the truth is that certain weapons, like the Interfacer or Greed, can spawn as sight none, which allows the player to move around very quickly while aiming down the sights. True, the zoom on a Bandit scope would still be better at this point. However, compared to other scopes, Bandit on average tends to possess the lowest zoom potential, making it the worst scope available. Maybe you could say that more conventional weapons that spawn with iron sights that are specifically designated by the game as scope none are worse than Bandit scopes, but as far as a specific tangible weapon part is concerned, I would say Bandit scopes are the worst. Much like some of the other weapon parts I'm going to be talking about, it's not really the end of the world if you have a weapon with a Bandit scope. However, it is important to be aware that pretty much every other scope or sight from other manufacturers provides superior zoom. So if you're looking for the best, or if you're looking for something that's decent, Bandit scopes certainly don't fall into either category. Number 8. The Stability Plus Accessory. Now, the Stability Accessory can be somewhat difficult to recognize across SMGs, snipers, pistols, and assault rifles. However, the important thing to keep in mind is that snipers and assault rifles have vertical grips, SMGs have this bulky protrusion that hovers over the stock, and pistols get a stock that extends out of the pistol grip. However, if you're unsure, I'll go ahead and I'll showcase what the Stability Plus accessory looks like while also showing some of the prefixes that your weapon could potentially have. So let's go ahead and start with SMGs. Here are snipers. Here are pistols. And then here are assault rifles. Okay, so with that out of the way, the problem with the stability accessory is not necessarily that it's bad and doesn't do anything, but rather that the bonus to recoil reduction is usually redundant. Especially if you end up getting a good stock on your weapon, like a Doll or Hyperion stock, as these either have great accuracy or recoil reduction to begin with. Therefore, you're better off with an accessory that increases weapon damage, improves bullet speed, or adds a blade attachment. So while it isn't a totally terrible accessory, it's not that great either, and I'd recommend most other accessories above this one. Number 7. Bandit Stocks. Now, technically, bandit stocks are available on rocket launchers in addition to assault rifles, SMGs, and shotguns. However, we're going to be focusing on the latter three for this entry. The problem with bandit stocks is that, unlike stocks from other manufacturers, bandit stocks on SMGs, shotguns, and assault rifles literally do nothing. You won't see any boosts to recoil control like you might see on a dual stock, or even any accuracy improvements that you might see on stocks from Hyperion. I suppose the upside to this is that you're not getting any downsides like reduced accuracy or poor recoil control. However, in the presence of other stocks like the Hyperion or Dahl stocks that don't have any penalties and solely improve the weapons that they appear on, doing nothing at all isn't especially all that great. I suppose I will concede that bandit stocks aren't the single worst stocks in the entire game, but they aren't especially great either. After all, you might find you can live with the better recoil reduction of, say, a Torque stock, despite its below average recoil recovery. So ultimately, while having a bandit stock on a gun isn't the end of the world, just be aware that there are better options out there. Number 6. Tedior Barrels. Speaking of weapon parts that literally do nothing, this brings us to Tedior Barrels. Aside from the Tedior SMG barrel, the Tedior barrel for launchers, pistols, and shotguns do literally nothing. While I suppose you could say this makes them not especially great or especially bad, the thing is that pretty much every other barrel available is usually better. When it comes to launchers, you have the Torg or Bandit barrels, which greatly increase damage, the Malawan or the Vladov barrels, which improve projectile speed and either accuracy or fire rate, and then you have the E-Tech barrel, which is just hilariously powerful when compared to the Tedior barrel. As for pistols, the Malawan barrel is basically similar to the Tedior barrel, however it receives bonuses to elemental effect damage and accuracy, while other barrels either have better base damage and or better DPS potential. This of course leaves us with shotguns, where you have the various Jacob's Double, Bandit Triple, and Torg Quad barrel variants, which all deal increasingly more damage, while the Hyperion barrel has tighter spread, recoil reduction, and accuracy at the cost of slightly decreased base damage when compared to the Tedior shotgun barrel. Like I said for bandit stocks, while I suppose it isn't the end of the world if you get a weapon with a Tedior barrel, I just think you'll find that the other barrels from other manufacturers are typically better and their redeeming qualities often outstrip their negative ones. So, unless you're using an SMG with a Tedior barrel, it's generally a good idea to avoid these on pretty much every other weapon type. Number 5. The Accuracy Plus Accessory. With the exception of the versions available on rocket launchers and maybe even the one on pistols, the Accuracy Plus accessory for SMGs, shotguns, assault rifles, and sniper rifles is usually a waste of your time. The best way to tell if you have one of these is usually by the prefix. However, I'm going to go ahead and show the corresponding weapon parts and prefixes that you need to be on the lookout for. When it comes to assault rifles, be sure to look at the stock, and you should see this cylindrical shroud attachment that is attached to the stock along with one of the following prefixes. When it comes to shotguns, it's more difficult to identify, but there should be a small box on the side of the gun with one of the corresponding prefixes as shown here. SMGs have a box on the side that kind of looks like a canteen of some sort and has one of the corresponding prefixes I'm showing here. And finally, sniper rifles have a bipod under the barrel and therefore can be confused with the crit accessory. However, if you check the prefixes shown here, you should be easily able to identify what accessory you have. Now, in some cases, this accessory would just be redundant, like it is on SMGs and assault rifles. However, with snipers and shotguns, you're getting debuffs in addition to the accuracy boost, which cover important attributes like weapon damage and/or recoil. So if you see this accessory on your favorite legendary weapon, you might want to refarm that and see if you can get a better version. Number 4. Jacob's Stocks. So, in my humble opinion, Jacob's stocks are truly awful and are available on snipers, assault rifles, and shotguns. The primary problem with these is that they increase your initial accuracy. However, they are known for their horrendous recoil control and recoil recovery, meaning it takes noticeably longer to return to maximum accuracy. I also think that Jacob's stocks also end up making Jacob's weapons virtually unusable, especially when it comes to assault rifles and snipers, where the ridiculous recoil makes it really difficult to consistently perform precise shots at range. In the later difficulties, where performing consistent criticals are a key to your success, the Jacob stock is a liability and could potentially get you killed. I guess the upside to these is that they do look neat. However, as a general rule, if you get a weapon that spawns with the Jacob stock, you may want to refarm it or just throw it in the grinder. Number 3. The Hyperion Pistol Barrel. Hyperion barrels in general tend to be less desirable on most weapon types, however, I think the Hyperion pistol barrel is notable for how lame it is. The idea behind this barrel is that you're supposed to be pinpoint accurate with it and continuously perform critical hits. By design, you're receiving improved accuracy, reduced recoil, and a 33% bonus to critical hit damage. However, this comes at the expense of the weapon's base damage and reduced magazine size, which I would say is the real problem here. While the magazine size penalties aren't so severe, the base damage is, and the sheer lack of base damage makes the Hyperion pistol barrel perform below average when compared to other pistols on body shots. And on criticals, this barrel doesn't even perform as well as either the Jacobs or Torg barrel when appearing on a Jacobs pistol. Even the Tedior barrel manages to ever so slightly sledge out the Hyperion barrel when it comes to damage on critical hits. The Hyperion pistol barrel really sucks, and you should just avoid it at all costs. Number 2. The Torg Assault Rifle Barrel. So, this particular barrel actually has a surprising amount of potential, and in the earlier parts of the game, you may even find that it's quite decent. This is mostly due to the Torg barrel's high base damage, which tends to scale well earlier on, as most enemies don't have insane amounts of health. However, as you progress through the game, you'll really start to notice that the Torg barrel has some flaws. In particular, you'll find that this weapon can't perform critical hits, which really puts a damper on its damage potential. Plus, I think you'll also find that the Torg barrel is held back by its fairly high ammo consumption. Now, the ammo consumption is largely determined by manufacturer, with Torg consuming a ridiculous 4 ammo per shot, Bandit and Doll consuming a less ridiculous 3 ammo per shot, while Vladoff and Jacobs consume about 2 ammo per shot. So, while you could potentially deal more damage per trigger pull, you're consuming anywhere between 2 to 4 times the ammo you normally would, and you can't even perform criticals, which is pretty lousy if you ask me. I guess what I will say is you might be able to get away with using one of these in the early game. However, as soon as you get into Ultimate Vault Hunter mode and the OP levels, the Torg barrel is far less viable, and potentially even terrible, depending on the version that you receive. And finally, number 1, E-Tech Pistol, Shotgun, Sniper, and Assault Rifle Barrels. I've just got to say it, but what a boatload of ass! With notable exceptions, including the E-Tech rocket launcher and SMG barrels, all other E-Tech barrels are pretty awful. And if you ask me, that's kind of a shame if you consider that most E-Tech weapons are fairly well balanced for some of the earlier parts of the game. After all, much like the Torg assault rifle barrel, these all have pretty high base damage, but they also are all pretty much guaranteed to come in an element, making them more lethal provided you match the element to the enemy's weakness. However, both like and unlike the Torg assault rifle barrel, E-Tech barrels are the victim of poor ammo consumption and either the total inability to perform critical hits or significantly reduced critical hit bonus. In particular, both E-Tech shotguns and pistols can't perform critical hits at all, while E-Tech snipers and assault rifles have significantly reduced critical hit bonus. So, by the time you reach UVHM, you basically have almost an entire rarity that has been gimped, which is very unfortunate. So, unless it's an SMG or a launcher, avoid E-Tech like the plague, especially once you reach the endgame areas or endgame difficulties. Alright guys, I think that's going to pretty much wrap up this particular video. If you liked this video, feel free to leave a like. click the bell so you can be notified when I upload more videos. And as always, thank you all so much for supporting this channel. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next one.